outside of Sweden to Uganda, Maria Haakonsson noted that midwives play a key role in the maternal and newborn health. She added that the Swedish government is willing to continue supporting Uganda's health sector.
We have seen reduced maternal mortality and child mortality. We have seen increased number of antenatal visits and deliveries at health facilities with skilled health workers.
In her message delivered by Dr. Charles Olaro, the Director of Health Services, the Health Minister, Dr. Jane Ruth Acheng, said the Health Ministry appreciates the work done by the midwives and they are ready to support them.
We also know that the outputs, the high-performing health center fees, deliver on average 70 mothers a month. So we are trying to look at that now. Since we have increased the structures, what's important now is advocacy to see that the midwives are actually recruited.
The UNFPA country representative, Dr. Mero Tieno, asked the government to consider the midwife staffing based on the World Health Organization standard by recruiting more midwives and doctors.
We recommend that the government of Uganda implements the new approved staffing structure to improve the midwife to patient ratio and help reduce burnout of an already overburdened workforce. It is also important that we come together to invest in one, innovation and technology for midwifery training.
Gamisha Caroline, one of the recognized midwives, hailed the Swedish Embassy and the Minister of Health for appreciating their work, motivating them.
Because without teamwork, nobody can reach to this. Yeah. And I thank also our ADHO for always supporting us.
According to the 2022 Uganda Demographic and Health Survey results, 91% of mothers deliver from health facilities. This is because many expecting mothers seek help and care from skilled health workers. Meanwhile, outstanding farmers have been awarded during the opening of the Farmers Symposium organized by Uganda Breweries Limited at Hotel Africana in Kampala. Pastor Robert Kayanja scooped a number of awards at the ceremony.
He's also one of those commercial growers that is having impact.
During the symposium, farmers have been urged to embrace modern farming technologies to increase the output and quality of their produce.
This allows us to put more money into the farmers' pockets, which in turn helps them to contribute to the various development programs in their communities.
In a speech, Pastor Robert Kayanja, the lead pastor at Miracle Cathedral Church, said that Uganda's soils are still very fertile and can support crop growth if farming is done in the right way. He gave an example of his projects of over 40,000 acres of land in Karamoja region that is known as the dry area.
Help farmers create their own capitals. And farmers here, we need to create our own capital. We cannot depend on another city's capital, Beijing, New York, Canada. We cannot. If we want Africa to be independent, if we want Africa to be wealthy, we cannot use prisoners to grow our food, neither can we use capital from whatever organization it comes from.
The 2023 Farmer Symposium has been officially opened by the State Minister for Agriculture, retired Major Fred Buino Chakulaga. He warned against land fragmentation, which is affecting the sector greatly. Chakulaga say that farmers should strategically choose the kind of crops to grow according to the acreage of their land.
When you go, if you look at Uganda from the aspect of sub-regions, you go to Busoga sub-region, what is the average land holding in the Busoga, for example?
Report compiled by John Musenze and Ismail Nsubuga for the news.